"Yes, but it's a lot of fun, if it is strange," remarked the small voice of the kitten, and Dorothy turned to find her pet walking in the air a foot or so away from the edge of the roof. "Come back, Eureka!" she called in distress. "You'll certainly be killed."
"I have 9 lives," said the kitten, purring softly as it walked around in a circle and then came back to the roof.
"But I can't lose even one of them by falling in this country, because I really couldn't manage to fall if I wanted to."
"Does the air bear up your weight?" asked the girl.
"Of course. Can't you see?" And again the kitten wandered into the air and back to the edge of the roof.
"It's wonderful," said Dorothy.
"Suppose we let Eureka go down to the street and get someone to help us," suggested Zeb, who had been even more amazed than Dorothy at these strange happenings.
"Perhaps we can walk on the air ourselves," replied the girl.
Zeb drew back with a shiver. "I wouldn't dare try," he said.
"Maybe Jim will go," continued Dorothy, looking at the horse.
"And maybe he won't," answered Jim. "I have tumbled through the air long enough to make me contented on this roof."
"But we didn't tumble to the roof," said the girl. "By the time we reached here, we were floating very slowly, and I'm almost sure we could float down to the street without getting hurt. Eureka walks on the air all right."
"Eureka weighs only about 1/2 pound," replied the horse in a scornful tone, "while I weigh about 1/2 ton.
"You don't weigh as much as you ought to, Jim," remarked the girl, shaking her head as she looked at the animal. "You're dreadfully skinny."
"Oh, well, I'm old,"
said the horse, hanging his head despondently,
"and I've had lots of trouble in my day, little one. For a good many years I drew a public cab in Chicago, and that's enough to make anyone skinny."
"He eats enough to get fat, I'm sure," said the boy gravely.
"Do I? Can you remember any breakfast that I've had today?" growled Jim, as if he resented Zeb's speech.
"None of us has had breakfast," said the boy, "and in a time of danger like this it's foolish to talk about eating."
"Nothing is more dangerous than being without food," declared the horse with a sniff at the rebuke of his young master, "and just at present no one can tell whether there are any oats in this queer country or not. If there are, they are liable to be glass oats."